get to do the show here in London. After I finish every tour, I always say, this has been the best tour yet. And I have to say that this is no exception. This is the best tour I've ever gotten to do. It's one thing to share music with people, but it makes it so much more meaningful when you can share who you are and the lessons learned, and hope that somebody can be inspired by that. They can go out and chase their dreams, and that's kind of a theme of my life. And so when people step into a Lindsay concert, I want them to just kind of take a step out of reality and come into my world. I'm really excited because this is my life for the last, year. And, it's all been poured into this show. So I'm really excited to let everybody get to see it that didn't catch it come out.
Thank you. believe it. We're already kind of towards the end of this tour. But before we started touring, I went to quite a few concerts myself because I wanted to be inspired so I could get some ideas for my own show. And not long ago, I went to a Lady Gaga concert, actually. And she actually did the coolest, sexiest thing. She basically had her backup dancers come on stage and fully change her outfit. And by the middle of it, she was basically down to her nothing. She was naked. And I thought to myself, you know, no one wants to be a copycat. So I could do this in my own very Lindsay Sterling way. Of course, with the overall objective to be super sexy. Theo, Pete, I told you Lady Gaga concert, not Nicki Minaj. Okay. All right. We'll get that right for the next show. Okay. Anyways, as far as my overall objective, though, of being super sexy, I mean, let's be honest, I kind of nailed it. Single person in this theater tonight is sexy. I really do. Give it up for yourselves for being sexy people. And the reason I say this is because I feel like the most attractive quality that anyone can have is confidence. Because if you have confidence, then you just carry yourself in a way that shows you know who you are, you respect yourself, you love yourself, and you don't really care what anyone else says about it. Because you know. And, I mean, that's what honestly makes people just gravitate to you and want to be around certain people. And sometimes it's called flair, some people call it charisma, and personally, I like to call it swag.
Thank you. Oh, there she is. Oh, yes.
Thank you.
Was that good?
I think that was.
Thank you.
Oh, it's feeling a little. That's okay.
Next time you touch that, you lose your fingers.
No.
Okay. Come here, Lindsay. Look at me and say that.
Yeah.
What a pretty... What are you?
Princess.
You're a princess. I like... Yep, yep, yep. I can't argue with that.
No. Oh no, it's a terrible monster.
With our friends and all, and we have all kinds of cool stuff like these glasses. We prepared one for each of our friends. We've got all kinds of confetti ready. We're gonna have a blast. So we'll be back with more facts when the actual party starts.
Yeah. Let's dance. Take your hand, Jennifer.
Say goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
I want to welcome back my amazing band to the stage. Please, everybody, give it up for Gabby and Drew. You know, it's pretty crazy. Gabby and Drew have been with me since my first ever show. It was over 2.5 years ago. I was so nervous, and I decided last minute, okay, I want to make this really legit. I want to have a band. And so I basically put the word out that I needed 2 band members and a keyboard player and a drummer to learn 17 songs in 2 days. Then get on a plane and fly from LA to New York City to play a gig with some random girl who did violin videos on YouTube. And basically there was only 2 people that offered to do the gig. They're right here. So, I mean, it's kind of funny. It was supposed to be a one-time thing, like just a one-time thing. This random girl, they didn't know who I was, and I haven't let them go since. But they've become my best friends. They've become the 2 older brothers that I always wanted. And I can't imagine having better people to travel the world with and, you know, to live my dreams with. So, one more time for Gabby and Drew. Kind of break it down for you right now and just do a little bit of an acoustic set for you, because it just kind of makes me feel like we're all just hanging out and chilling, like in my living room or something, like old times. So this is an acoustic version of Transcendence. that I have learned over the last 2 years of touring that I'm actually very proud of. It's come to my attention there are 6 couples that have met at a Lindsey Stirling concert or on one of the Facebook fan groups. And they've not only dated, but they've gotten married. So, with this being said, I've decided several things. First of all, I'm going to start a dating website.
I got one, Linz. Sterlingmingle.com.
Nice. Maybe, Gavi, you might have more luck on my dating website than you do on Tinder, so just saying. Oh, man. Ladies, I just have to say, I can't believe it. Somehow Gavi is single. Can you believe that Gavi is single? I mean, see?
I'll be out there after.
Yeah, he'll be out back after the show, so. But anyways, the whole point of this was we want to play you guys a love song, a romantic love song, because like I said, maybe one of you will find your special someone. They could be just a few smelly, sweaty people away from you. So, with no further ado, we're going to play you what I think is one of the most beautiful love songs ever written, and I need your guys' help. Let's make this a beautiful starry night sea here in London tonight. London, that's one of the most romantic cities in the world. Let's live up to it.
Thank you.
write to my music. Most of my music is instrumental, and so I only get, you know, one word in the title to express what the whole song is about. And so I really seek to create emotions. When I was writing this next song, I wanted it to express what it feels like to be hopeless, and then what it feels like to reach and find hope. Sometimes I think we have to take a few steps into the darkness before we can see the light, and there's always someone just a few feet away waiting to help us, whether it's family members or friends in my own life. But even more importantly, I can remember a specific time when I really was all alone and no one could understand what I was going through, and it was then that I really, really realized that I believe that God knows each one of us. I believe that He hears and He can answer prayers and He can be there for us. And this next song is about my experience in finding hope. And that's why I called this song Take Flight.
for Mr. Pete Styles, everybody. So we're going to have a little dance-off, a little battle to show how talented these two dudes are. They're amazing. You need to see how amazing they are. Cheer for your favorite, which will probably be Pete. Have some fun. Let's do it.
in the best way possible. Wow, thank you. But I need you guys to please give it up one more time for Gavi on the keytar. Holy cow! It's a battle. It's a battle every night between me and Gavi as to who wins. And I think you won tonight, Gavi. That song we just played is called Roundtable Rival. That was one of my favorite music videos I've ever done, because, I mean, I love playing dress up. Sometimes I dress up like a cowboy. I've dressed up like ballerinas before, or Link from Zelda. I've even been a pirate before. guys, thank you so much. Thank you for being such an incredible audience tonight. I can't believe that I get to come and share what I love with all of you. I was told over and over again that I was just too different. I didn't have what it took to be a professional musician. But you guys are the ones that started watching my videos and sharing them, and I can't thank you enough. I have the best fans in the world, the best friends in the world. I feel like you guys are my friends. You know, there was a time in my life where I was way too afraid to be different. I was suffering from anorexia, and I basically covered myself in this shell of what I thought was perfect and what I thought everybody else wanted me to be. I can vividly remember the way I felt when I would look in the mirror at myself, and I just hated everything that I saw in that mirror. And it was because I had forgotten who I really was. And from this experience, I learned that you cannot love anyone else until you first learn to love yourself for who you really are. And I know that every single one of you guys is so different. And sometimes we're told that that's a bad thing. But even though I was told that was the reason I would never succeed, I feel like that is the very exact reason that I have. And so this song is about my experience in breaking free from my own boundaries. It's called Shatter Me.
Yeah! Vibrate the glass, then.